हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी अनदर क्वेश्चन ऑफ पॉट एंड सीपीए। सो दिस क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्क्ड इन गेट 19 अगेन। ओके, सिंस देयर आर टू शिफ्ट। ओके, सो इन द मॉर्निंग शिफ्ट दैट क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड एंड द इवनिंग शिफ्ट दिस क्वेश्चन इज आस्क्ड। सो वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन। ओके, सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी टॉक्ड अबाउट मच दैट how to do the questions in network PERT and CPM. You again see activity duration and precedence relationship is given. It means again you have to draw the network diagram. Which network diagram? Activity and precedence. It means you have to draw the network diagram in which activity is present on the node or event is present, activity is present on the arrow or event is present on the node. Okay, so we will read the question. Read the question. The activity of a project, their duration and precedence relationship are given in the table. So activity duration and precedence relationship is given. And for example, it is saying that, for example, in a precedence relationship, x less than y z. Okay, you can see a less than b c d, b less than e f g. Okay, a new type of precedence relationship has been given. So it has been explained that what does it mean. It means that x is precedence to, x is precedence to y and z. So you can say that if a is less than b c d, it means a is precedence to b c and d, b is precedence to all the three activity e f and g, c is precedence to I, d is precedence to g, e is precedence to h, f is precedence to I, g is precedence to I, h is precedence to I. So everything has been told that x less than yz means x is precedence to y and z. So they are asking the time to complete the activity along the critical path is. Okay, options has been given 25, 21, 17 and 23. So they are asking that find the duration of the critical path. Okay, you already know what is the critical path. It is a path which is going to consume the maximum duration. Okay, it is the path which is going to take the maximum time. So the time is given in weeks. Okay, the time is given in weeks. So what you have to do, we have to draw the network diagram first. Okay, we have to draw the network diagram first. So we will draw the network diagram first. The first activity is activity A and it is starting first. Okay, you can see activity A, and activity A is precedence to B, C and D. It means the activity A is the first activity. Okay, no other activities. For A there is no precedence. Okay, for A we have got no precedence. A is the precedence to B, C and D. So the activity A will start first. Okay, we can draw it like this, that activity A has been started first and the time is 5. Okay, we will write the time later. And you can see activity B. Okay, activity B. And activity B will start when? When will the activity B start? Activity B will be starting when the A has been finished. You can see for B the precedence is A. So we can draw from this node B, C and D. Okay, B, C and D. So activity B, activity D and activity C. Okay, because A, you can see A is the precedence to B, C and D. This is less than sign. Okay, so it has already been expressed that what does it mean. Now B, okay, B is the precedence to E, F and G. Okay, B is the precedence to E, F and G. So we will draw E, F and G. So this is E, F and G. Okay, we have drawn the rough sketch here. Okay, we have drawn the rough sketch here. Now look at activity C. Activity C is the precedence to I. Okay, we don't know I, so let it be. Okay, we will draw it later. Okay, we will draw it later. Okay, we will draw it later, that we don't know where is activity I. So activity C is precedence to I, so you can draw I here, but let it draw later. Now look at activity D. Activity D is the precedence to activity G. Okay, activity D is precedence to activity G. So you can see that B is also precedence to G and D is also precedence to G. So one thing you can do, that since G is starting from here, so you have to draw this, it like this. Okay, D. Okay, you can draw D like this. Okay, and remove it. Okay, remove it. So it is correct? No, because look at B and D. These are going to have same head event and tail event. It means we cannot draw it like this. So we will have to take the help of dummy activity. Okay. We will have to take the help of dummy activity. We cannot draw G here. We cannot draw G here. So how we will draw? We can see. This is D. Okay, this is D. And activity G, you can see the G in for G, B and D both are the precedent. So we will take a dummy here. D dash. Okay, we will take a dummy here and we will draw the activity G. Okay, now it is correct. Okay, now you can see that D is the precedence to G and B is also precedence to G with the help of this dummy, and our network rule is also followed. Now activity E is precedence to H. So activity E is precedence to H. So H somewhere here. Okay. Activity E is precedence to H, and activity F is precedence to I. Okay, F is precedence to I. G is also precedence to I, and H is also precedence to I. It means F, G, and H, they have to match at the same point. Okay, F, G, and H. So just draw F here. F, G, okay, and this H. And which activity is coming? Activity I. Okay, like this. Okay, activity I. Okay, the last activity, we have left C. C is the precedence to I. So we will draw C there also, like this. Okay, you can see. Now we will write the time duration. For A, it is 5 weeks. For B, it is 7 weeks. For C, it is 10 weeks. For D, it is 6 weeks. Okay, for dummy it is 0 weeks. For E, it is 3 weeks. For F, it is 9 weeks. For G, it is 7 weeks. For H, it is 4 weeks. And for I, it is 2 weeks. Now we will name the nodes. Okay, according to Fulkerson's rule. So this is 1, this is 2. Now we will cut those which are coming from here. Okay, so look here, this is having an incoming activity, that is dummy activity. So it is 3. Okay, this is 3. Now we will cut all the activities which are emerging from here. So this can be 4 and this one is 5. Now we will cut this one and this one. So it is going to be 6 and this is 7. Okay, so we have drawn all, we have named all the nodes. Now we have to find the critical path. Critical path is the maximum duration. Okay, maximum duration. So we can see the different paths: A, B, E, H, I. Okay, this is the first path. The second one is A, B, D dash, G, and I. This is the second path. So here the time will be 5, 7, 12, 3, 15, 19 and 21. Here it is 21 weeks. The second one is 5, 7, 12 and 12, 7, 19, 19 and 2, 21 again. Now the third path can be A, B, F and I. 5, 7, 12, 12, 9. 21 and 21 to 23 weeks. Okay, another path you can take AD. You can take ADGI. So it is 11, 7, 18, 18 to 20 weeks. Okay, now you can also take AC and I. Okay, AC and I. This is 15 and to 17 weeks. So which is the maximum? You can see. This 23 is going to be the answer. Okay, since it is consuming the maximum duration, this is the answer. Okay, so very simple one. A, B, C, D and ई. ओके, वेरी सिंपल नेटवर्क डायग्राम. एंड द वेरियंस ऑफ द ईच नेटवर्क डायग्राम, ईच पाथ इज गिवेन 4, 16, 4 and 1. सो वी हैव टू फाइंड द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन. वी कैन राइट स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इज इक्वल्स टू अंडर रूट ऑफ सम ऑफ वेरियंस. ओके, अंडर रूट ऑफ सम ऑफ वेरियंस, दिस इज द क्रिटिकल पाथ फ्रॉम ए टू ई. सो हाउ विल यू राइट, द वेरियंस इज गिवेन फॉर 1, फॉर ए बी इट इज 4, देन इट इज 16, देन इट इज 4 एंड देन इट इज 1. सो यू कैन फाइंड 25. ओके, सो दिस इज 5 टाइम यूनिट. ओके, सो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन ऑफ द क्रिटिकल पाथ ए ई. ओके, सो वेरी सिंपल क्वेश्चन डायरेक्टली बेस्ड ऑन फॉर्मूला. ओके, सो एवरी टाइम हाउ टू फाइंड द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन, स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इज अंडर रूट ऑफ सम ऑफ वेरियंस. सो वेरियंस ऑफ ईच ऑफ द पाथ इज गिवन. ओके, वेरियंस 4, 16, 4 एंड 1, दिस इज गिवन. सो जस्ट कैलकुलेट द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन. सो दिस वॉज द सेकेंड लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन पार्ट एंड सीपीएम. जस्ट गो थ्रू दीज न्यूमेरिकल्स, वेरी सिंपल बट कॉन्सेप्चुअल वन. थैंक यू.